Greetings, people. Paul Mucker here. Today is March 11, 2014. Greetings, my friends, my families, my soul rebels and my spiritual warriors. Great victory for us today. When I win, you all win. My people, as those of you who have been watching me know, for the past 7 years, since March of 2007, me and Mr. Rothschild in London and his weasel attorneys here in America and these wolves, these judges and his foxes have been locked in a deadly battle over my home. Because they've been trying to take me from my home, people, since 2007, March 2007. Because, people, real quickly, right? Anyway, I got judgment in my favor, just to let you all know. But real quickly, right? These people, me and my mom, applied for a mortgage in 2006. And these people, my mom had perfect credit. And these people got hungry when they seen her credit score. So they committed fraud against her, falsified my mom's income, falsified all my mom's assets, right? Instead of using mines, they falsified my mother, destroyed her name, right? Just so they could sell her mortgage at AAA. And committed fraud against us, right? And then had the audacity to try to raise my mortgage payments, $1,700 more than it was in one whack. So I said, no, I refuse to pay. So they said, okay, we're going to foreclose on you. I said, then come on, bring it on. It's going to be war. So people, I refuse to pay the mortgage. I refuse to accept the higher payments, right? And so they tried to foreclose on me and I sued them and I won. But it was too easy of a victory, and I really wanted to help other people, so I told the judge he got to give that victory to everybody else in Brockton who was having problems with their mortgage, because I know the banks are coming to fraud against everybody, because I inspect other people's loan too. So the judge said, that's good, but I cannot do it for you because you're not an attorney. So you have to look out for yourself. So I went to the weasel attorneys and I said, listen, they are weasel because anybody who tries to take people's house away from them got to be a damn weasel. So anyway, I went to these weasel attorneys and I said to them, listen, go to your client and tell them that they got to give a break to everybody who having problem with their mortgage. You got to give them a break, because if you don't give them a break, it's going to be war. I'm going to refuse to pay you anything and I'm going to fight you. So they laugh at me and they said, bring it on. I said, okay, come on, let's go. So I sent them in federal court. The federal judge would have fought my case. He said, I didn't cite any law that the banks broke and I need to look out for myself and accept my win in Brockton and look out for what's good for me and my family. And I didn't accept that. I learned the law and I went back and I showed him the law that the banks had broke. So he said, you're right. So he took my case and I won. But I said, okay, you have to give it to everybody in America now, because now I'm in federal court now, and if I win a case, if I prove to you that the banks commit fraud and I show you they commit fraud, you have an obligation to inspect everybody loan in America to see that there's no fraud. So you gotta give the victory to everybody. The judge said, no, I'm not gonna do that. He said, I can't. I said, yes, you can. He said, no, I can't. I said, yes, you can. Then I said, well, I'm representing the people. He said, no, you can't represent the people. I said, yes, I can. He said, no, you can't. I said, yes, I can. So he said, well, you need to look out for yourself. I said, if you don't give it to everybody, it's going to be war. So they refused to give it to everybody, so it's war. So he ruled against me, say that me and my mom commit fraud against the banks. Me and my mom commit fraud against the banks. So anyway, I took it as an insult, because my mother is the most honest person I ever met in my life. That lady, and this judge had the audacity to look at the evidence and accused my mother of committing fraud when the evidence is right there before his face that the banks committed fraud against my mother. But he looked out for his people. Okay, so let me leave it at that. So anyway, he ruled against me and he gave them the bank my house. But I said, you aren't going to take me out of this house. You don't have to drag me out of this house. It's going to be blood. I said, it's going to be blood like rivers running in the streets of America if you actually are going to drag me out of this house like that. I told him that. So, I threatened revolution. I said, it's going to be a revolution. So these people now, they try to bribe me. They offer me $130,000 to fix their house. After I don't give my kids back up to their mother now, they want to come after me $130,000 to fix their house and $100 mortgage and pocket money if I shut up and drop the case against them. Now, I don't sue the government now. I sue Barack Obama and everybody now. So now they all get scared now. Oh, let's bribe him. Let's pay him off now. So I said, no, I'm not for sale. So anyway, people, they couldn't buy me. And they couldn't bribe me. So they sold me. The federal judge and the weasel attorney for Mr. Rothschild. And Mr. Rothschild owns SG Mortgage, which is Société Générale, a bank in France that's owned by Mr. Rothschild, who lives in London. Okay, so anyway, that's his personal bank right there. His father created it. Nathan Rothschild created Société Générale in 1816 in Belgium. Okay, and now his bank is in America, taking all mortgages. So anyway, Mr. Rothschild attorney, Weasel attorney, and the federal judge teamed up against me. And people, this is one of the biggest law firms in America, people. One of them people, one of the partners is an ex-governor of North Carolina, okay? The other partner, an ambassador to England. The next one, an ambassador to Canada. The next one was the head of the Small Business Association. The next one was the head of the education department. All these people are former government agents fighting against Paul Merkel. Could you believe it, people? I'm my own attorney. These are some big shot attorneys, former government employees. Siding with Mr. Rothschild. They are defending Mr. Rothschild and Wall Street against little Paul Merkel, a former governor of North Carolina. Okay? A former head of the education department. A former ambassador to England. A former ambassador to Canada. A former head of the Small Business Association. A former lobbyist. People, that's some big shot attorneys who are in this firm fighting against Paul Merkel. Okay, and we have defeated them. So anyway, people, I went off track a little bit. What I was trying to say to people is that they couldn't buy me, so they sold me. They set me up, said I tried to kill this judge. I tried to plant water bottle bombs in his yard and in his mailbox, him and his weasel attorney. And that I threatened to kill them, and that I wiretapped them, and that I stalked them. Okay? That's what they charged me with. Why? So they could put me in jail so they could sell my house. But people, when they locked me up the first time on April 13, 2012, they were supposed to sell my house on April 17th. I bailed out on April 17th. They didn't think I could bail out under those charges, but I bailed out April 17th. So they postponed the foreclosure. So what they did, people, I sent my family and my friend an email with pictures and a video showing them that when I was locked up, the federal marshal and the Brockton police robbed my house. They stole my ganja, they stole my money, and I have my stuff out of my house. And I took the video and I sent it to my family, tell them to keep it for my safety. And these people went into my email account, people, and hacked my email account and sent the video and my email to the weasel attorney and arrested me for what? For sending him the email, because they told me, they say I was harassing him. So they arrested me on May 1st, and on May 2nd they sold my house when I was locked up. So when I came out of jail now, and I got back in my house, they offered me $8,000 if I gave them the key and vacate the premises in 2 weeks. I laughed at them. So now, they served me 72-hour notice to get out. Are they going to evict me in court? I laugh at them. So they sued me. They went to court and sued me. They tried to evict me. I laugh at them. So they took me to court now to seek possession of the property. So now I'm schooling the law now. So I said, show me your credential. I don't care if the federal judge give you permission to sell my house. I don't care if the Supreme Court of the United States gave you permission to take my house. We're in Massachusetts now. We are under Massachusetts law. I said, before you could evict me from my house, show me, prove to me and this judge that under Massachusetts law, that you follow every step, that you dot all your I's and you cross all your T's in your steps to deprive me of my home. So now, people, This is what they said to the judge. They sue me, people. They sue me. Right? And I demanded, okay, show me your credential. Prove to me that you had permission to sell my house and evict me out of it. So this is what their response was, people. They asked the judge to protect them. To protect them from having to answer to me. This is what they say. Plaintiff motion for protective order. Plaintiff U.S. Bank National Associate as trustee for Rothschild Mortgage Securities Asset-Backed Certificate move this court to issue a protective order relieving it from its obligation to respond to the written discovery propounded by defendant Paul L. Merkle in this matter. Merkle's discovery is overly broad, unduly burdensome, and not reasonably calculated to lead to the discovery of admissible evidence because it seeks information that relates to defenses and counterclaims that are barred as a matter of law. So people, you see this? They're trying to prevent me from forming a defense. They're trying to take my home, but I shouldn't be able to defend myself. I should shut up. So anyway, this is what the judge ruled. The date of the argument was August 7, 2013. 7 months ago, people. That's how long ago we were in court. 7 months ago. We did the oral argument. And we present our written arguments also. So, the judge, this is what the judge ruled, right? U.S. National Bank Associate as trustee for SG Mortgage, Rothschild Mortgage Security Backed Certificate. Plaintiff versus Paul L. Merkle defendant. Judgment. This action come on for trial hearing before the court, Edward J. presiding, and the issues having been duly tried, heard, and finding have been duly rendered. It is ordered and adjudged under Rule 10 of the Uniform Rules of Summary Process that judgment, this in plaintiff's summary process action, and defendant's counterclaim issues without prejudice. Accordingly, judgment enters at 10 a.m. on the 7th day of March 2014, pursuant to Massachusetts General Laws, Chapter 239, Section 5, an aggrieved party must file a notice of appeal with the court within 10 days after entry of the judgment. People, I don't have to appeal. They didn't want to appeal because I got everything I wanted to leave me the hell alone. So anyway, people, Let me go on and explain more what the judge ruling was about. This is the judge memorandum and order. So as Pante memorandum and decision and order of judgment dismissing complaint. This is a summary process action in which the plaintiff, U.S. Bank National Associates, plaintiff or U.S. Bank seeking to recover possession of a residential property at 35 Newberry Street, Brockton, Massachusetts, the premises. Following a foreclosure sale, the single-family house is occupied by the defendant Paul L. Merkle, the defendant R. Merkle. Defendant Merkle obtained a one-half interest in the premises from his mother Irene Wood, the original mortgager. Defendant Merkle has been self-represented. Irene Wood had not taken part in any of these proceedings, nor filed an appearance. For the reasons set forth below, the plaintiff's summary process action is dismissed without prejudice for failure to name and serve Irene Wood as a necessary party pursuant to Massachusetts Rules of Civil Procedure 19A, B, and C. Further, the court will dismiss without prejudice the defendant's counterclaim in this matter for judicial efficiency, which means that the judge dismissed my counterclaim for the same reason he dismissed the plaintiff's counterclaim, because the ruling is on my behalf. So there's no need for him to address anything else. The plaintiff cannot kick me out of my house. So anyway, let's go on. Procedural history and undisputed fact. On May 5th, 2006, the defendant mother Irene Wood granted a mortgage to Mortgage Electronic Registration System, acting in its capacity as a nominee for Fremont Investment and Loan. Later that day, would convey a 50% interest in the premises to the defendant as a joint tenant subject to the mortgage. Okay, let's skip down here. The defendant, which is me, was served with a 72-hour notice to quit and vacate premises on June 27, 2013, in which the plaintiff sought possession of the property. On July 15, 2013, the defendant was served with a summons and complaint in which the plaintiff sought possession. The plaintiff does not seek use and occupancy, notice to quit, and summons and complaint filed court. Decision and order dismissing action. The court finds that the plaintiff has failed to serve Irene Wood, the original mortgager and joint tenant. Irene Wood, as a joint tenant and former mortgager, has an indispensable party interest in the premises, pursuant to Massachusetts Rule of Civil Procedure Rule 19. I'm not going to read all of it, but what it's basically saying is that because my mom is joint tenant in the property, the banks cannot seek possession of the house and kick me out without making my mother a part of the lawsuit. So the court is basically saying that no, you cannot evict him. You have no power to evict him unless you serve his mother, who is part owner of the property, with notice. And this is what he say here. The plaintiffs have presented no pleading, affidavit, or other document to indicate that Wood has waived her rights to occupy or has vacated the premises. After a review of the extensive pleading in this matter filed by both parties, there was no documentation to indicate that Mrs. Wood was a defendant in a separate summary process action. Accordingly, the court must dismiss this matter as Mrs. Wood is a necessary party to this action. So, order of judgment based upon all the credible testimony and evidence presented at trial in light of the governing law, it is ordered that plaintiff summary process action is dismissed without prejudice. The defendant counterclaim are also dismissed without prejudice. People, check this out, right? That was my argument to the court, because people, they were trying to evict me from my house, like I said, right, without involving my mother. And I laughed at them and I said to them, here, this is my argument to the court. This is my argument to the court, people. Page 46 of my argument to the court. Merkel respectfully moved this court to not consider Judge Woodlock's rulings and decision, because Merkel expect those rulings to be invalidated and overturned by Irene Wood in the event her son's home is taken away. Judge Woodlock ruled that Merkel had no standing to represent his mother. That being the case, Judge Woodlock had no standing to rule that Irene Wood had committed fraud, because Irene Wood was not a party. So this was my argument to the court, okay? How could Irene Wood be a party if the same judge who allowed Merkel to represent her turned around and ruled that Merkel had no standing to do so? Surely, if the house is taken away, Wood would sue because all her rights were violated. So you see, people, because of that argument I made, right? Because of that argument I made, the judge had no choice, because he knew anyhow he ruled against me and kicked me out of my house, my mommy, my queen, okay? Because this is a chess game. And I've been telling them, my mother, that's my queen, okay? And she's in the cut watching what y'all doing to her son. And when you all think that you are gonna take her son of prey, my queen gonna pounce on you all. I warned you all, okay? I warned you all, because of that love, people. Because my mom loved me so much to help me get a house. And because I chose to show her love back by giving her half of the house, now me and my mom are joined. And because they didn't serve my mother, they violated all my mother's rights. So this is my counterclaim. But what was my counterclaim? My counterclaim was that if you take my house from me, my queen gonna come and pounce on you all. Okay? And I asked the court to what? Dismiss the complaint. So I won. And now they might come back, people. They might try to serve my mother, but guess what? My queen is on the war path, okay? My queen is ready. She's ready to pounce on you all. Anyhow, y'all come and try to serve her with an eviction notice. My queen is ready to pounce on you all. So anyway.